Hello friends, welcome back to Best Ready Study. In this video, we are going to see how to get a job, how to prepare for an interview, and how to answer HR questions confidently. Okay, so the companies have already begun recruiting the people who are going to pass out in the next year, that is 2020. So now hereby we should be a little bit serious regarding our jobs, and on campus is one of the best source to grab a job. Okay, so how to get a job is the most common question of almost all the students. Okay, so first question is how to start preparing for an interview. Okay, there will be different rounds of interview based upon different companies. Most of the companies will have first round as the CRT round, that is the written test. It is also called as written test. In written test, you'll be given general questions, that is aptitude, that is quantitative aptitude, reasoning, verbal questions, where you need to solve all the questions and you need to cross the cutoff successfully in order to go to the next round. First round is written test. In the first round, I already told you what are the questions which are going to be, like you'll be having questions on quantitative aptitude. Quantitative aptitude means you'll be having questions on mathematics from 4th class to the 12th, whatever mathematics you have, from those parts only you'll be asked, nothing beyond that. Coming to verbal and reasoning, you should concentrate on the logical thinking questions, logical questions, time management, as well as you should concentrate on your vocabulary as well as grammar. Okay, so you should be good at English, not so pro at English, but you should have at least basic English skills. Okay, basic communication skills. So after successfully completing and crossing your cutoff, you'll be going to the next round. Coming to the second round, you'll be like, few companies will be having a technical round, or few companies will be having group discussion, depends upon the various companies. So coming to the group discussion, let's just think that you have group discussion as your second round, and this is optional round. Most of the companies will not have the group discussion, they'll have directly the technical round. So coming to the group discussion, a person will be monitoring a group and their discussion. Okay, before the group discussion, they'll be giving a common topic, a normal general topic which you can easily discuss with the group, and they'll be giving you a specific time, say like 10 minutes to discuss. And the thing is, you have to discuss, and before the time is up, you have to also end the topic, give the topic a conclusion, give your discussion a conclusion. Okay, so coming to the group discussion, what are the do's? Okay, first let's see what are the things you need to do while group discussion. First thing is, always remember, the person who is monitoring you is seeing whether you are capable of teamwork, because in every company there will be a team project, not independent or individual project. Okay, so coming to freshers, coming to the, as an individual, you should always be ready to mingle with the team, cope up with the team. Okay, so he or she who is monitoring you will observe that how well you're going with the flow, with a sea of people. Okay, so always be polite in the group to each and every individual. Okay, this is first do. And the second do, like the thing which you need to do is, once the person gave you the topic for the group discussion, just think the sensible points. Okay, don't talk whatever you want, just think whether whatever you are talking, is the point valid or not. Okay, just talk sensibly. And the third important thing is, concentrate on your communication. Okay, you should be using good words, simple words. You need not use the difficult words where no one understands except you. It's not like that. You should always communicate using the simplest language and which is easily understandable by your peers. Okay, and fourth one is talk in a good language with politeness. Okay, with politeness when you talk, like you should use good language in the sense don't make grammatical mistakes. Talk with a basic and good English. And the fifth one is give each and every person opportunity to talk. Okay, don't stop anybody. Give them opportunity to talk. So now let's see what are the don'ts. Okay, these are the things which you should do. Now I'm going to tell the things which you should not do while group discussion. The first one is you should never stop a person while he or she is talking or while he or she is telling her point of view. Okay, never stop any person, never deal them arrogantly, always talk to them politely, never deal them with aggressiveness, though they are your enemies or though you don't like that person. Always be polite, never do aggressively, never deal with them aggressively. So these are the don'ts points and a few tips which I would like to give you so that you can easily crack the group discussion is the person who starts the discussion will be getting a bonus point. The person who concludes the discussion will be getting a bonus point. So you should be the person who is either starting the discussion or concluding the discussion, and you should also talk in between. It's not that I started the discussion, I'm done with my work. It's not like that. You should start the topic and continue it in between, as well as you should end the topic. And before ending the topic, also you should add your own points in between. Okay, so after you're done with your group discussion, then there will be your technical as well as HR round. In few companies, these rounds will be separate, like first technical and then HR. In most of the companies, it will be like together, technical as well as your HR round. So coming to the technical round, what you need to do is first coming to your core subjects, like whatever stream from excuse me, from whichever stream you are. At least be perfect with one subject, and whenever the technical HR, like the technical person, asks you, like, what is your favorite subject, or which subject excites you, or in what subject, or in what area you're good at, tell that one subject which you are really good at so that he or she will be asking questions from that particular subject only. Okay, this is coming to the technical round and coming to HR. They'll be asking you the general questions, nothing about subjects or knowledge. It's all general questions to test you. Are you really interested in this job, or you just attended it for time pass? And they'll also test you how how loyal you are with your answers and how truthful you are to your answers. Okay. So they'll also observe your behavior and personality. So first, what you need to do is sit straight, put your body posture always straight, never lean or never bend on the table. Don't do that ever. And coming to the few questions coming to the HR, tell me about yourself is one of the most common question which every HR asks. Why will they ask this question? Is that to make you feel comfortable? Okay, so we know about ourselves very well. So first question HR will be asking is tell me about yourself. It is comfortable question. Okay, so coming to the tell me about yourself, please tell only about yourself. Okay, understand the question and tell only about yourself. Don't tell the things which is related to your parents, friends, relatives and all. Just tell him only about yourself, him or her. Just tell them only about yourself. And the second one is try to tell the points which are not in your resume, because your resume is already in the hands of HR. He or she has already read those points. Don't repeat these points again and again. Just tell the points about you which are not mentioned in the resume. Okay. So, coming to the next most common question, they'll ask you is, why did you choose our company or why should we hire you? Then you should tell all the good points, all the positive points about you. Okay. All the strengths about you. So that they should feel that you are the correct person for this particular role. Okay, so if it is for database, like if it is just for DBA role, tell that you're good at DBA. Tell that what are the certifications you have done. Tell that how much you love that company and your job, how much passion you have about that job. All those things will really impact your job and you'll get the job for sure. And the next most common question which the HR asks is, what are your salary expectations? They'll just ask this question in order to see, are you present at the interview just for money or out of passion? For this particular question, like how much salary you're expecting for this particular question, don't tell the answers such as, I want the highest paying job. No, don't tell that. Don't tell too high. Don't show them too high expectations. And don't tell that I would love to or I would love to work for free. Okay, don't tell such kind of fake answers also. Be diplomatic according to my skill. If you're a fresher, as I'm a fresher, according to as per my skill and knowledge, I hope the company pays me as per the market rules, okay? Market terms, market conditions like that, okay? So such kind of diplomatic answers you should be giving. And the another most important question is, why, what if we don't hire you? They'll ask this question in order to see how will you respond to that question, okay? It will tell them like how well you can handle the negative situations. If you're not selected for the job or if you're not getting the job, they wanted to just observe how well you can handle with such kind of negative questions. So they'll ask you, so don't get tempered or don't be sad for this question. Take that or tell that you're going to take this interview as an experience. And I'll just find out what are the mistakes which I've done for this interview, and I'll try not to repeat them for my future interviews. Such kind of diplomatic answers you should be giving. So I hope you found this video useful. This is most requested video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. Also, don't forget to like and share this video. And if you have any queries or if you want me to do more and more such kind of videos, don't forget to let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching, and all the very best for your interviews. All the best.